j minus 1, right? Let's just say this value is m, okay? Not m, because m we considered here, there, right? So let's just consider this value is capital B, let's just say. Then this, the value a of j, xor a of j plus 1 dot 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 till a of k should be equal to, this should be also be equal to b, because these both are equal, right? So now if you look closely, these are supposed to be continuous elements, right? From I to j and from j to k. So what I will do is, I will let me write in round in form of an array, right? So it will be a bit clearer to you. Let's just say I started from here, okay, and j is here and k is here. So what this means is the value till here is capital B, and the capital XOR value till here is again capital B. Okay, so the trick involves here is, if you see from I to k, the continuous XOR will be nothing but B XOR B, which is 0, right? So the question simplifies to, from a of XOR from I to k till k, a of k is equal to 0, because b XOR b will be 0. So if I start a continuous XOR from I should reach till k with a XOR value of 0, okay, right? So this, now this question is comparative simpler, right? And if you see how to find that, so and for j, how means, let's just say we found some I, which is, let's just say, equal to 2, and we found k equal to 7. Now what will be the value of j? Do I need to iterate again to find where is the value of b? No. See, if you see the array, let's just say this is the small subsection from I to k, right? Now if you see here will be some number m, and till XOR or till here will be 0, right? So if I want to find, and one more thing, let's just say this continuous XOR is 0, right? So if I want to find the XOR value of only this, then how will I find this, right? How will I find it? So basically what I will just do is, or this part, right? If I know the XOR value of this part, let's just say this was B, right? Then what will be the XOR value of this? That will be nothing but 0 XOR B, which is again B, right? So at any place I can consider J, right? If I consider here J, then whatever will be the M, right? So the next remaining part will be 0 XOR M, which is nothing but M again, right? So if I have any I and K, then I can have K minus I J, right? Because I can consider J from anything between I and K, because the final result value is 0, right? So if I XOR any of the, means like any consecutive XOR from that, the next part will be also same, right? Now let me give an example just for sake of simplicity. Let's just say we had let's just say we have a continuous XOR. What I will do is, to solve this question, I will maintain on next slide maybe. Let's just say we have an array A, right? Array A we have. Here we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I will maintain another array B, which will be nothing but a cumulative XOR till that position. Any BI means B of I is equal to A of 0 XOR A of 1 XOR dot 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 till XOR A of I. Okay, so how will maintain that? B of 0 is equal to A of 0, so this will be 1, and B of 1 equal to B 0 XOR B 1, so this will be 1 XOR 2. Okay, that will be 3. Okay, and then similarly, so B I equal to B I XOR B I minus 1. right? So this will be 3 XOR, sorry, this will be AI. Let me just erase it and write clearly. This will be AI XOR BI minus 1, okay? This is B1 and this is A1. My mistake, sorry. AI XOR BI minus 1 will give me the consecutive XOR. Means that till, let's just say I want to find XOR till I equal to 4. I have a direct value. I will just query B of 4, okay? So like this, I have a cumulative XOR array, right? So basically now what I will do is, I will just see starting from any position, right? Where is zero value basically, right? I have this B value, B is the cumulative XOR, right? So if at B of K, at what should be the value of B of K? It should be equal to zero. I explained earlier, right? It will be B XOR B, so that will be zero. So if I have a continuous 1, 2, 3, something like that, 4, 5, 6, 7, then here 0 suppose, right? So this will be my K value, right? This can there can be more zeros ahead also, 1, 2, 3, let's just say, then again 0, right? So this will be also a K value for I equal to 0, right? For I equal to 0, we'll have some K values. Let's just say k1, k2, right? So for each I, we can have multiple K values. So how to find, how to find, this is for I equal to 0, because we have at any index starting from A of 0 to A of K, right? We have a continuous XOR, right? But how to find from A of 1, do I need to maintain another array? No. Let's just say I want to find A1, means A1 to AK, right? How will I find this? What I am saying is, let's just say I had from A0 to AK till AK I had, right? Till any number. If again I XOR A0 to it, I am removing basically A0, right? This will give me A1 till AK, right? So if I want to remove till A2, I want to remove, right? And I want only from A3, right? Then what I will add is BI XOR A0 XOR A1 XOR A2. And this is again nothing but again B2, right? So BI XOR B2. This will give me from any I to K value, okay? So basically now what we can have is multiple subsections, right? Let's just say we had here to here I equal to, right? We had I equal to 2 to K equal to 6, right? Now another I want to find is which starts from 4, okay, till 8. So what I will do is, now I will start, just basically I have a loop from starting from I equal to 0 to N. I am considering that each of the position is I, and then I am checking if B of, then again I am checking for J equal to I plus 1 to N, if B of I XOR B of J XOR B of I minus 1 is equal to 0, right? Then this will give me another K case, because what I'm doing here is removing the earlier elements, like, and if this I minus 1 is less than 0, I'm taking this as 0, right? Because if you're at I equal to 0, you don't have to subtract anything, right? So basically like that, and I'm iterating that array till I find any B of K which is equal to 0, right? Hope I made it clear, right? Now, but basically this is again a N square approach. Basically you are iterating from each of the elements till the last one and finding a K value, right? So this is this will give you a partial correction, but what should be the right what should be an efficient approach is, if you see here, if you see carefully, what I'm doing is I'm finding out I'm subtracting an earlier value and checking if this is coming to be zero, right? So if you see b of j XOR b of I minus 1, now this should be equal to 0, right? So basically, what is b of j basically then? It is nothing but b of I, because then only if this is m, then only this will be true, right? So what you can do is, so basically what you are finding is same elements in the b array. So what I am saying is, sort the array, use a stable sort, okay? Let's just say sort stable in b, right? And find means you can keep another class, let's just say class position, right, which has the key value and the position value, and you can sort the objects of this position value, okay? Sort of position, right? So you will have you sort it based on the key value and you will have the position with you, right? So then let's just say something appeared 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 5, right? So if you see here, what was the position value? Let's just say the position was 3 and here the position was 5, here the position was 1, here the position was 6, here the position was 2, here the position was 4, here the position is 7, let's just say, and here the position is 8. Okay, let's just say randomly any position I allocated, right? So if you iterate the sorted B array, you will see 3 to 5 1 array is there, right? So if you see this is nothing but I value and K value, right? So you have J value respectively as K minus 1 values, right? So you have for these two values this number of J, so that is the number of triplets, right? And again, if you see this is not same, then for these two, right, you will have 1, 6, right? Or similarly, you can have 3 elements also. Let's just say you had something like 3, 3, 3, right? And here position value was 1, here position value was 2, here position value was 3. Let's just say here position value was 5. So basically, this can be I and this can be K, or this can be K, right? For 1, there can be 3, 5, right? 2. And for a position value of 3, you can have only 1. Similar, so basically you have to consider all cases, right? So once you found one I, you have to check for K, right? And till the values is same, right? So then you don't have a n square approach. Basically just you are checking if b of I plus 1 is equal to b of I, right? And then you are just calculating based on the position value. Now this B is nothing but a separate class object, which will make your job much easier. Then you don't have a n square approach, you have a linear search, right? So order of n solution. So hope I explained you well. If you have any doubts, you can post it in comments. You can go through my code. I will put it in the description. Okay, happy coding. Thank you.